In 1914, World War I began, and this led to over 70% of all males in the UK being drafted into the armed forces. The only males left behind were those under the age of 16 or over the age of 61. This led to roughly 8 million men leaving the workforce to fight the Axis and free the world. Obviously, this left over 8 million occupations abandoned and therefore needed to be filled. The only people left to fill this void were women, and this moment right here is where the future of the dating market would be ruined forever. And if you think I'm exaggerating, let me explain over the course of this video why I am not. When women entered the workforce during World War I, this was of course a necessity as there was nobody else to perform these duties. The companies did not want women and women did not want these jobs, but unfortunately, neither party had any choice in the matter. The vast majority of women had been housewives and been more than content with that. For the last thousands of years, gender roles have existed, and somehow our species survived to this day. So that clearly works. So why did it all change? Well, as I stated, women took over males' jobs and were actually paid less than male counterparts to do the same roles. Fucked up, I know, but when the males returned, things went back to normal. Men went back to work, women went back to baking pies, creating a home, and raising the next generation. That is, until World War II happened, where the same thing happened as in World War I, except the companies decided to pay the women even less than the first time, because women were seen as cheap labor that were too naive to understand how to negotiate. Sadly, this was true. But once the men came back from World War II, and, you know, saving the world, women then joined the workforce on a permanent basis. Meaning that instead of having around 8 million jobs with around 8 million members in the workforce, they now had the exact same amount of jobs, but with over double the number of people in the workforce. Obviously, this caused quite the dilemma. When you have equal supply and equal demand, things go very smoothly. But when supply and demand aren't equal or similar, this can lead to a lot of problems. The main problem being twice as much competition for jobs, and when a job has 50 applicants instead of 10, it means that companies can pick the cheapest worker and demand them to be more efficient, or they'll get fired. And who were the cheapest workers? Women. Because as I said previously, they lacked the ability to negotiate at the time, and I assume they were just happy to have a job at all, let alone if it only paid £2 an hour. Fast forward a number of years to the modern day, and we find ourselves in the current terrible situation where men and women don't make enough money individually to afford basic necessities such as food, heating, rent, and medication. The fact that some people have to decide whether they eat or get their medication for this month is a disgrace and a failure of the government. But yes, women are earning average money and men are earning average money, but unfortunately, the majority of women don't really want to work 40 hours a week, and when you have aspirations of having a family, I don't really fucking blame them. Unfortunately, a small loud minority of women have led this reality to be entirely impossible for the majority of women, and here's why. The average yearly salary within the UK in 2020 was £38,600, which is roughly $48,000. The average household expends £29,640 per annum, meaning the average household makes a profit of around £9,000 a year. Now that sounds fantastic, right? Well, it would be. But unfortunately, those household expenses only account for rent, fuel, and power. The basics of existing, like eating, commuting, and medication, on average total a whopping £6,700, leaving you with around £2,300 a year of profit. Combine all of this with the fact that everything is far more expensive nowadays, and you come to the understandable conclusion that no family can survive on a single income household anymore. Bearing in mind this also doesn't take into account so-called luxuries such as cleaning equipment and certain amenities, I won't continue with the numbers, but I think you get my point. It just keeps getting worse, and this is just the average income. So think about the millions of people living below that line. Bearing all of that in mind, it's not surprising when you see that so many women want a man that will lead them and their future family into a situation where they never have to worry about whether they have to choose food or medication for that month. The researched number applied to this is around £70,000. This amount of money would be enough for you to never need for anything and never be in any financial problem. This, of course, leads to the majority of women wanting a man that earns in the region of £70,000, or $87,000. In the United Kingdom, only 5.2% of males earn upwards of £70,000, and in a poll done in 2017, 3,000 women aged between 18 and 30 were asked how much a man needs to earn for them to be interested in a long-term future. 73% answered above £70,000. So, almost 73% of women want only about 5% of men. Does anybody else notice the problem here? This leaves around 95% of men being ignored by the vast majority of women based solely on how much they earn. I haven't even mentioned things like height, weight, and other physical traits that females find desirable. And not to mention that of those 5% of men that earn upwards of £70,000, almost all of them are over the age of 40. So unless young women are willing to marry men almost double their age, I sincerely suggest they lower their expectations. Because I know what the modern day feminist will say. Well, why don't men just earn more money? Well, it's not that simple. People spend their entire life trying to earn and save money. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. But they can't, so they don't. Now, I have no problems with women wanting to date men twice their age. If you want financial security, then that's your decision. But it is impossible for a 25-year-old male to be earning the same amount as a male that has lived twice as long, earned twice as much, and has had twice as much time to accrue the money he has. Everybody is entitled to their own preferences, but that does not mean you're entitled to get what you want. And that right there is the problem with the majority of young modern day women. 73% of women competing for 5% of men, and they all expect to be the ones that are chosen. When those 5% of men don't want those 73% of women, it genuinely makes these women mad to the point that they start screaming about there being no good men left. There are good men left. There's plenty. You're just too delusional to realize that you are the problem and that your expectations need to be realistic. Unfortunately, I don't think there is any real solution to this situation. The moment women entered the workforce, this problem was inevitable, and the fact that women entered the workforce in the first place was also inevitable, as society has continuously leaned toward total equality for both genders, regardless of the positivity or negativity of the outcome. Whilst this concept isn't a problem, the lack of care, preparation, and responsiveness to the situation we now find ourselves in is. So, what can we do about this? Well, women need to stop complaining about not being able to get that 5% of men that clearly don't want them and focus on building themselves to the point where they don't need a man that earns that much in the first place. If they are truly set on being a housewife, then accept that you are not going to have a 5-bedroom home with a 2-car garage and your very own gardener. You don't need to have a mansion in order to be a housewife. You just need a home with a husband and some beautiful children. And that's all you need. Being a housewife is not a lifestyle. It's a career choice. And it's one I truly, truly admire. Whereas men need to avoid wasting their time dating women until they are at least 25, because before 25 years of age, you have very little to offer in the dating pool. You are either just entering the workforce, still in university, or just about to leave university, meaning you have a fuckload of debt to pay off. This debt you do not want hanging over your head when trying to fund a family, because I believe I can speak for the majority of men when I say that we want a housewife. This is of course not possible if women expect you to earn twice as much as the average man. You will of course meet women that are conscientious, considerate, and emotionally mature beyond their years. These women are the type of women that will be willing to build with you, but unless you get lucky enough to encounter this woman, just focus on yourself, finish school, learn a trade, or learn something actually useful at university, not gender studies, fuck that shit, and enjoy yourself whilst being as morally ethical as possible. Being a good man to those around you, that's all that really matters. Please remember that sperm doesn't have a use-by date, so you are in no rush to have a family of your own. Focus on yourself and your current family first, because that attitude will translate to other avenues in your life. Regardless of whether you agree or disagree with my opinion on this topic, please comment down below, as I love hearing your thoughts, positive or negative. Thank you all for watching, I hope you are all doing well, and as always, take care.